In today's episode, I'm going to show you three simple prints to upgrade your Ender 3. One of them helps prevent your extruder from wearing out, and I'm also going to use a little Tinkercad to make it easier to install so you don't have to buy any extra hardware. And I'll show you two other prints that are really handy. So stay tuned, I'll show you all of it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by these Patreon supporters. One of the features of the Ender 3 I don't like is the spool holder on top. It's added weight when you have a really full spool, but more importantly, it's the angle of this filament. It's being pulled at a hard angle on the extruder. Now, I tried this on my CR10, and it didn't take long before I figured out that it's cutting into the extruder arm. I had a nice groove cut into that thing, and it was resisting movement. And so I said, let's move it back to where it is on the side, and that's what I'd like to do here. Move the filament over here on the side so it's straight into the extruder and therefore less resistance. Now it does make the printer a little bit wider, but it's much better for the printer in the long run because I'm not going to wear out the extruder arm. But I needed to mount this bracket on an angle and I found this one on Thingiverse. It's the Ender 3 side spool mount by user Dr. Street. This bracket is a nice design and it mounts perfectly right here to the back of the machine, but it requires a screw and a T-nut for both the side and the top, although the top one is really the main one. And then you need two more screws and two flat nuts to hold the bracket to this. And if you don't have the T-nuts and screws, I'll put a link to this kit, or these two kits right up here. They're very handy to have in the shop, but you probably spent enough for Christmas. And so what I wanted to try to do is see if I could just use the two screws and T-nuts that hold this to the rail and a little 3D printing to make this fit without any screws. So let's import this into Tinkercad and I'll show you how I modified it to make it work on the Ender 3. Tinkercad.com is a free software for doing this. I imported the STL file in, and then there's two cutouts here for the nuts and then two holes to make the screws fit easier. And you can see where I'm cutting it out when I make this into invisible mode here. And then here's the piece that's actually going to slide into the 2020 rail. So then when I make this solid again and I group all these together, the cutouts are going to make the holes bigger and it's going to join that little triangular piece and I have my bracket. So this is what I did in Tinkercad. Brought it into Cura, printed at a 0.2 layer height, 50% fill, 200 degrees temperature, 60 degrees in a bed, 60 millimeters per second with a skirt. I clicked prepare and it said it would only take 1 hour and 34 minutes to print. When you're designing a custom 3D print like this, here's a little trick. Only print part of it. I printed just enough so I could test this on the rail and make sure everything fit. That way I didn't waste a bunch of plastic and find out the thing didn't fit. If you do that 2 or 3 times, it becomes a real pain, plus the time you lose. So I just print a little thin piece like that, test it, and that way I know when I do the final print, it's gonna fit. Now to install it, the first step is to remove the old spool holder and then take those T-nuts off and slide them into the new slots that I made in the part. And you can see the holes line right up. And so now I just need to put the bracket against it and slightly tighten the screws so it holds, and then flip this over and finish tightening the screws all the way so this bracket and the spool holder become one. So now it's ready to be installed on the machine. So I pop off the little black plastic cap that covers the end of the extrusion. This is on the Ender 3 Pro, that's why it looks a little bigger. And it slides right on. It'll work on the Ender 3 or the Ender 3 Pro. Then I put the cap back on. And now let's test it. So the filament spool fits nicely. You can bring the filament in straight into the extruder, no rubbing on the arm, right into the gear and into the PTFE tubing. I'm sure some people will worry about the filament hitting the threaded rod. It really doesn't, but here's a guide just in case it is. It's really for a CR10, but it fits the Ender 3 just the same. It's got this little loop that you flip over the filament and then it just snaps in place. No screws or nothing required. The filament will rub against it, so it defeats the purpose a little bit. I don't think you really need it, but some people will want it. That's why I included it. And you can print a new one if it ever gets too bad. Another print that I highly recommend is this extruder knob by user TechBoner. And it's got a flat spot here to match the flat spot on the extruder arm. This should be able to just push right on. You shouldn't have to lower your gear. You could if you want, but it just pushes on with plenty enough grip. And now I can easily move this filament in and out. Very, very handy. Three very simple prints to take you from this to this. And I really like it. But what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. If you like what I'm doing here, check out some of these videos that are popping up. If you want to help support the channel, just buy through the affiliate links in our description below or support me on Patreon. And if nothing else, click on that Chep logo and subscribe. I probably won't see you before Christmas, so have a Merry Christmas. But I will see you before the end of the year, so I'll see you next time, right here on Filament Friday.